Now moving on to BLS International, a small cap stock that has been in focus, and the stock has gained over 50% in the last 1 year and has gained in four out of the last five sessions actually. So the stock has been buzzing. To discuss more about the company's performance, we are now joined by Mr. Shikhar Agarwal, who is the Joint Managing Director at BLS International. Mr. Agarwal, good afternoon. If you could tell us what kind of recent business growth you have seen, some key contracts that you have achieved.
Good afternoon. Yes, so BLS has been building the capability for the last 10 years, and you know, we've processed around 20 million applications till date. The fact of the matter is we've grown this much that this year itself we'll process 18 million applications. This is on the basis of the capabilities that we've developed in the past, and recently we backed the Spanish contract.
Right. Mr. Agarwal, your first quarter earnings were really good. I can see there was a substantial jump in terms of EBITDA margins as well. What can one expect from the second quarter? Can we expect margins throughout the year to be in that range of 20 to 22%?
See, the contracts for the government of Punjab and government of Spain that we won was in around the last quarter of the last fiscal. So the revenue is starting to kicking in from those contracts this year. So the margins are definitely going up. So first quarter was, I think, the best quarter for BLS till date. The entire profit for the year FY16 we achieved in the first quarter of FY18. So I feel the margins are going up and we can expect a steady growth in terms of growth for BLS International. So in next 2 years, around 25 million applications are up for tender, in which BLS is now pre-qualified. So we feel that we will grab a sizable market share in the coming quarters and coming years. So the growth should be from the organic and inorganic business both.
Mm-hmm. And what kind of success have you had so far in the e-governance contracts? Any update on that and anything in pipeline?
So see, we won the Punjab government tender in which we opened 2,147 centers and employed more than 5,000 people. The effect is more than 60,000 people are coming every day to our centers. On the basis of this project, which is one of the biggest projects in under Digital India and under Captain Sahab's approach, we've also backed the contract by the government of Afghanistan in the entire Middle East. We are in fact the first Indian company to grab that, wherein we will be registering all the citizens from Afghanistan and issuing them ID cards. Going forward, we feel that a lot of Indian states are also coming out with similar tenders because it is very beneficial for the citizens. And also abroad into African market and into Asian market, we are focusing on expanding our e-governance.
Mr. Agarwal, things are looking good for your business. I just want to check, how are you looking to reward your shareholders? What's the kind of dividend policy that you're looking at for this year and for FY19 and FY20?
So we have already started discussing the dividend policy between the board members. So in the next board meeting, hopefully we will have a very good dividend policy for our shareholders, because this is the long-term target for BLS, you know, to benefit our shareholders and the employees of the company. So I think going forward, we will have a very robust policy that benefits all the stakeholders of the company. As the company grows, we want all the people to benefit from the growth of the company.
Well, thanks a lot, Mr. Agarwal, for taking time out for us. BLS International, that's it.